finally time. Here we go. First game of the season right here. But first, we're going to cover some breaking news that I just got a hold of. I've been flying all morning. I'm broadcasting from my old room here in Dallas, Texas. I've only got so much time to make this video, but I wanted to address this game, but also the fact that OU President David Bourne has expressed interest in other conferences and said, we're going to be looking at our options, whether it takes 3 weeks from now or 3 days from now. That's right, we might have an answer by Labor Day. Who knows? But I find this attitude to be rather refreshing because, in the end, I called the Big 12's demise last summer, and I was all about keeping it in with the original teams, you know, when it was just Nebraska and Colorado leaving. So, you know, okay, I knew this was just a band-aid that was going to last 3 or 4 years. But now that A&M's leaving, that's kind of put the nail in the coffin, and this conference is going to go even quicker than we thought. And as far as OU is concerned, look, as an OU fan, I don't give a crap about the conference. Whatever is best for OU to go, that's what I care about. And in all honesty, as a fan, I'm still shooting for the SEC West. I mean, I know the SEC made an offer to OU last time, but, you know, the heads of the universities, the Board of Regents, everyone, they're all buddy-buddy with the boards and regents over at Oklahoma State, so we got to take them everywhere we go, apparently. Apparently, we're a package deal, and the SEC doesn't want Oklahoma State. I don't blame them for that. But who knows what this will do? Other people are saying we'll go to the Pac-12. We will be a part of forming the Pac-16. I'd much rather go to the SEC because, in all honesty, I find this whole thing rather refreshing because Texas fans need to stop drinking the Kool-Aid. They don't run the show anymore. It's going to be every school for themselves. And if we go, the Big 12 goes. Because, I'm sorry, we've won the most championships. How much revenue have we brought this conference? How much attention have we brought this conference? Texas doesn't run this show, and they're just delusional if they think they do. And the SEC fans need to stop drinking the Kool-Aid, too, because you could try pulling off that argument with Texas A&M being a lower-ranked team if they go to the SEC. OU, if we go to the SEC, yeah, we're not going to see too much success in the first few years as we see how the SEC runs. We're going to get smacked around a few times, but eventually we will learn how the SEC plays, and we will play the SEC just as tough as they play us. And I'll be interested to see how these SEC teams favor in Norman. But just think of the matchups. OU and Florida could be a rivalry game. Think about OU Alabama, OU LSU, OU Arkansas. We fit right into the SEC West. Arkansas is right there. LSU is right there. But that's just my take on it after all. Now, let's move past that and just focus on the Tulsa game right now. Tulsa coming into Norman. OU is favored by a lot of points, and that's completely accurate in my mind. In my mind, the greatest strength that the Tulsa Golden Hurricane has is with quarterback G.J. Kinney. Kinney's a legitimate quarterback. I mean, he's the best quarterback in the Conference USA as far as I'm concerned. But outside of that, I don't see much of a challenge coming from Tulsa. Now, I do think, and I am happy that they are presenting this challenge in this quarterback to this defense early on. Because this defense has just the right amount of older starters compared to younger starters, so they can work together as a cohesive unit. It's going to be a challenge for DeMontre Hurst, Aaron Colvin, Jamel Fleming. They're going to have to come up and see what they can do against a dynamic passer like G.J. Kinney. They're going to have to prove their mettle. And so are the linebackers. The defensive line, if they can't get to the quarterback, which I know they will, then the linebackers are going to have to prove their stuff too. Now, from what I've heard, Tom Ward is the one who's going to be wearing Austin Box's number 12 jersey to honor him, and I think that's really awesome. But in reality, Tulsa is a good team. I see them scoring 21 points on us. I think that's reasonable, but they cannot compare to the offensive dynamo that we will have. And it'll come down to the defense to see how they can stop G.J. Kinney. If they can stop G.J. and make Tulsa have to run it more, which is not their strength right now, that's how you stop them. You make them one-dimensional, and you eliminate the one advantage they've got. Other than that, we are going to score a lot. I'm saying 42-21. That's what I'm calling for this game. OU's going to win big. It's going to be a great crowd there in Norman. It's always a great crowd. It's always a sellout crowd no matter who we're playing. And I know because I was a student there. I just graduated back in 2010. Even if it was the season opener, we still sold it out and we still cheered on for the Sooners. And I like how this team and these players aren't looking ahead to Florida State right now because I think we might have gotten caught up in that. We definitely overlooked Utah State last year, and Utah State almost made us pay for it. But I like how they're really concentrated on Tulsa. You can see it in the interviews. They're just excited to be hitting another different kind of jersey as opposed to their own. So that's my prediction. OU wins big over Tulsa, 42-21, but I still see G.J. Kinney putting up some good numbers on this defense as the defense comes together to try to see what their unit's going to be, how they're going to work together. So, guys, that's all for now. Boomer Sooner, we'll see where OU looks to go. We'll see what happens in the next few weeks, I guess. All right, guys. Raw Oklahoma, fight for OKU. Let's get this season started. Catch you guys later.